You win tomorrow night. You become the first undisputed champion in the four-belt era at 147. You also become the first male boxer to be undisputed champion in two different weight classes. How much does that mean to you, being the first to do that?
Well, when I become undisputed in two world class weight divisions, you know, it's going to be great. You know what I mean? I'm going to pay homage to the man that got me here, and that's Jesus Christ.
Well, I'm going to break his will. I'm going to break his mental, his physical. Shit, I probably broke his spiritual. I'm going to break everything.
That being said, I gotta give an honor to God. Gotta thank him. Gotta always thank him. Cause without him, none of this would be possible. You know? And what Jeezy said, I used to have nothing. I feel that in my heart, in my soul.
Your time, but it's not your time, Tyson. This is my time, and it will forever be my time until I retire. I'm sorry to tell you that because I still
believe. Let me tell you, all that stuff you just said, you're already beat. Anyone who has to have an alter ego and not be themselves in there. And trying to get in someone's mind like
it
that.
Is. I'm not
you
trying to
can't
get in
beat
mind.
Me.
It's
and if I'm not talking to Deontay Wilder, let me talk to the other person you inside you, the bronze bomber.
I'm not trying to get in.
You're looking
mind.
At a man who stands in the light.
I don't want you
I can't
have,
be beat by any alter egos. Him win fights. Only the power of God above. That's it. And I get the power from that. I don't get the power from anything else. I don't need a second person to come and help me.
Don't you feel
you and your alter ego are a pack of bums.
Don't you feel the ancestry, the energy?
I don't feel nothing. You ain't got no power. Power in what? I felt the ultimate power from above, mate. But the power I'm feeling for
you
is negative. Negative energy.
You ain't felt that because I told you a long time ago I'm going to baptize you.
Yeah, well, let's see if you can baptize
me. And I'm going to show you, I'm going to put the spirit inside of you.
100%. I don't want anything that spirit that you claim. I don't want.
It's going to be your God against my God.
Time and
it's going to be your God against my God.
Time and time again.
If I do take a life in the ring, Deontay will feel bad. I'm going to feel bad as the man that I am.
Go back a little bit.
Nah, I want a body on my record. Mm-hmm. I want one.
God damn. Don't.
I want one. I want one. I really do. Like, yeah. But, you know, that's the bronze bomber. Like, he want one. You know what I mean?
In there, taking a good long look at Deontay Wilder as he shoves him back after the exchange. Oh. Right hand and down he goes.
There it is.
Deontay Wilder is back.
That's what I said. Don't get hit by that right hand.
Man, my only concern is when I always have concern for all fighters. You know, I'm a big advocate for fighters because. Like I always say, we get done wrong. This is not a sport. A sport is something you play. You don't play this now. And we seeing what happened. Look at Cologne.
Talking about Richard Cologne.
Richard Cologne. That's Richard Cologne.
Yep.
Correct. This man ain't have no kids. Man, they don't understand, man. Y'all don't fucking understand what we go through, man. And I don't even know him like that. But I always be an advocate for us because this man would never know what it feel like to be somebody's father. And that's some of the precious thing in the world, to be somebody's father. But he'll never be nobody's father, man. This man will never have a natural childhood ability of living again because he got in the ring to support his family.
Because I'm in no way, shape, or form Jesus. Been hearing they calling me street Jesus. There is a real Jesus. When he baptizes you, you go to heaven. Street Jesus, if you get baptized by me, you know where you go, right?
Uh-huh.
Shadow realm, baby. You know? So I just want to make that abundantly clear.
I want to give myself the birthday present of knocking him out, man. It's no disrespect to Nate, he's one of the toughest dudes on the planet, I can tell you that. But for me to win the way I wanted to win, I just wanted to baptize him, you know. But I still got 3 stoppages in 1 year, which is more than most of my coworkers could for the whole career in a lifetime. 2 of them being knockout of the year, so I am happy for some of the stuff I've done this year.
By unanimous decision, and still the undisputed UFC welterweight champion.
Cardio. This time he was able to fight through round one, and he still feels good and confident fighting round two.
And of all the superlatives.
All the props to him in the world. He caught me by surprise. He's got my number, man. There's nothing I can say, but he won this fair and square, and God bless him, man.
Classy in defeat, sir.
Me and Jesus are cool. I'm cool with all the gods. Gods recognize gods.
How would you and you versus Jesus in the octagon? How would he fare?
Me versus Jesus in the octagon.
Welcome to TMZ.
Now, how would me versus Jesus in the octagon? I tell you what, there's not a man alive that can beat me. But Jesus ain't alive, is he? So I don't f***ing know. Maybe he could come back from the dead. Not, I don't know. I'd still whoop his ass.
You said it, you called it, and you made it happen.
You know, first and foremost, I want to say thank you to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I said, those who bring evil against me will not prosper. I said, those who stand in the dark can never come into the light. All praise be to the one and only true God, Jesus Christ.